When Apple launched the iPhone 7, Cook & Co. gave us a comprehensive 10-point list on why this is the most resplendent of all iPhones so far, from a water-loving redesign to a sexed-up camera that's all better for low-light photography. But is it worth an upgrade if you already own an iPhone, and how does it compare to the very best Androids?
This is the gold model of the iPhone 7. It's just arrived in the UK. You can buy it now from Apple Store and various high street stores. Basically, all of the networks are stocking it. We've got the 128GB version, courtesy of 3. So let's crack it open and take a little look at Apple's latest gizmo. So, of course, designed by Apple in California, as per usual. There is the iPhone itself. In there, you've got just your bit of documentation stuff, nice and simple. Pop that aside. Let's slip this bad boy out. Be very careful with it, obviously. So there it is, the shiny new gold edition of the iPhone. Just gonna have a quick look, just make sure it's got some battery, and have a quick look in the rest of the box. So what have we got? We've got Apple's usual 3-pin adapter. Always handy. We've got new funky earbuds, which are, of course, connected via the Lightning port, or you can have them wireless as well. So we'll have a check of them. And you also get the standard Lightning charger as well, so you can get that all charged up. And that appears to be it in the box, nothing else. Nope. That is it. Nice and straightforward and simple, as per usual. Let's pull it in the right way. Let's take a little look at the iPhone itself.
Like the iPhone 6 and the 6S, the 7 is once again a 4.7-inch blower, which looks pretty much the same front on. But look a little closer and you'll notice some rather important changes. Sure, those aerial bands on the back are gone, whoop-de-doo, but more importantly, the headphone jack has been axed in favour of some extra speaker action. If you want to keep your old wired headphones, you'll have to use the bundle 3.5mm Lightning adapter, which is about as much fun as a dose of the clap. However, you can also use any headset with a Lightning connector, like the one that Apple bundles in the box, or upgrade to a pair of Bluetooth wireless phones. Another big design change that you can't actually see is Apple's new water-resistant build. You could finally drop the iPhone 7 in your pint glass or the bogs without having to tolerate the smug, knowing smile of an Apple genius the next day. And as usual, the iPhone 7's metallic frame is pleasingly rugged and scratch resistant, although we can't personally vouch for that glossy jet black model that all of the emos love. Apple's screen tech is usually pretty solid, so understandably the iPhone 7 doesn't change things up much. Once again, you have a 4.7-inch Retina display which offers pin-sharp visuals, and even more realistic images now that the colour gamut is wider than ever before. The screen is also ever so slightly brighter, but as we didn't have any issues with reflectivity before, it's again a bit of a moot point. And as usual, you get full 3D touch controls, which most people will probably forget even exists. As for audio, the iPhone 7 now boasts some seriously powerful stereo speakers, which rival even HTC's boom sound blowers. These produce some seriously loud sound, which can happily cut through the piercing background noise and fill a small room, although they still sound a bit tinny when turned up. If you like carrying around a big media collection, then good news. Apple has finally ditched the crappy 16GB base model, and now the iPhone 7 starts off with a much more impressive 32GB of storage space. However, there is still no support for microSD memory cards, so you'll have to stump up for the more expensive 128 or 256GB models if you want more room. Beneath the iPhone 7's screen, you once again get a nifty Touch ID fingerprint sensor. This proves just as responsive and accurate as ever, although it's not actually a button anymore. Instead, it's just an indented surface that offers vibration feedback when tapped. With built-in pressure sensitivity, there's a chance that could be used for some really neat shortcuts in the future, but at the moment, it doesn't do anything out of the ordinary. iOS 10, of course, comes pre-installed, and it adds lots of cool new features to the iPhone while also updating plenty of existing apps. Check out our guide to iOS 10 over at recombu.com/mobile for a full overview, but the improved notifications menu, the handy Today View screen, and the boosted command center all make for a much more streamlined iPhone experience. And iOS 10 runs nice and nipply too, thanks to Apple's super hardcore A10 Fusion processor. Like the iPhone 6S before it, you get a pleasingly smooth everyday experience. Those lovely iOS animations and transitions look great, and you won't see a single stutter as you zip through Apple's menus and sweep from app to app. That said, iOS 10 is still a wee bit buggy at launch. We've already had to reboot the phone a couple of times and also reinstall some apps which refuse to play ball. Here's how to get the most out of your expensive new gadget with some awesome hidden tips and tricks. Tip 1. How to quickly erase a message. If you start to type a text message but then you change your mind and decide to say something completely different, don't bother mashing the backspace key. Instead, just give your iPhone 7 a quick shake and you'll be asked if you want to delete the entire message. Handy. Tip 2, customize the new home button. The iPhone 7 and 7 Plus both feature a new home button, which isn't actually a button at all. When you push it, that clicking sensation you get is actually just vibration feedback. If you want softer or stronger vibration, just head to the settings menu and then general, followed by home button. In here, you can choose between 3 levels of feedback with the option to test each level before selecting your favorite. Tip 3, notifications hack. Simply pulling your phone out of your pocket or lifting it from its resting place will now briefly activate the iPhone 7's display, allowing you to quickly check for any waiting notifications and messages. However, if you're constantly neglecting messages because you forget to check, you can go one step further and actually make the iPhone 7's camera flash ping on and off when something is awaiting your attention. To activate the notification flash feature, go to the iPhone settings menu. Now just go to General, and then Accessibility. In here, you'll see the LED flash for entries alert, and just give this a tap to activate it. Be aware, of course, that your iPhone's battery life will likely take a hit if the flash is constantly going on and off. Tip 4, get to grips with Today View. If you swipe your finger right from the lock screen or your first home screen, you'll bring up Apple's new Today View. This gives you a quick glimpse of all of your most important info, as well as shortcuts to your most used apps. You can easily add a new widget to the Today View, remove an existing one, and change their order about. Just scroll to the bottom of the Today View panel and tap Edit. Poke the minus icon next to any existing widget to make it disappear. And you can also add new ones by tapping the plus icons. And to change their order, just hold down this icon to the right of a widget and then drag it up or down with your finger. Tip 5, make the iPhone kid friendly. In the iPhone 7's settings menu, head to the restrictions setting. In this pin protected menu, you can set up various parental features. Handy if your young one is going to be handling the handset. For instance, you can prevent the installation and deletion of apps, you can disable App Store purchases, and loads more besides. You can even prevent movies above a certain rating from being downloaded, and restrict what websites your child can browse. No more smutty sites for you, Junior. Tip 6, how to use Wi-Fi and mobile data at the same time. If your chosen Wi-Fi network is a bit ropey, taking ages over absolutely everything, then you can use Apple's own Wi-Fi Assist feature to use both Wi-Fi and mobile data at the same time. To activate Wi-Fi Assist, just head to the iPhone 7 settings menu and then tap Mobile Data. This may be cellular if you're living in the States. From here, scroll down and you'll see the Wi-Fi Assist option. Just make sure that's switched on by giving it a quick tap. Tip 7, use your Apple phone for DIY. You might not think that your precious iPhone can also double as a handy DIY tool, but there is a nifty level built in there that not many people know about. Just tap Apple's Compass app and then swipe your finger left across the screen and the level tool pops right up. Now you can see the exact inclination to make sure those new shelves are perfectly straight. It's the same old song and dance every year, so just keep an eye out for an update or two in the coming weeks. Battery life is better than ever on the iPhone 7 thanks to the boosted battery size. You'll comfortably make it through a full day even with pretty regular use, and most likely make it to the 36 hour mark before the battery demands a charge. Of course, if you start shooting a lot of video and streaming a lot of Netflix, then that performance will be impacted. But you should still happily get around 9 hours of video playback on a single charge, which is better than most modern mobiles manage. On paper, the iPhone 7's rear camera doesn't sound too different to the snappers slapped on the back of the 6S, the 6S Plus, and the dinky SE. However, although the megapixel count hasn't been bumped up, Apple has sexed up the shooter in other key areas. So how much difference does Apple's tinkering actually make, and is the iPhone 7's camera much better than those older iPhone optics? Let's check it out. If you've used any recent iPhone, then you'll immediately be familiar with the iPhone 7's camera app. You once again flick up and down the screen to nip between the different modes, with the likes of photo, video, panorama, slow-mo, and time-lapse all available as usual. In photo mode, the iPhone 7's autofocus is as nippy as ever when lighting conditions are respectable. You can manually focus with a quick tap of the screen, which allows you to manually adjust the brightness levels too. There's a timer mode, filters, and HDR settings to play around with, as well as a quick shortcut for activating the flash and for switching to the front-facing 7-megapixel camera. Capturing shots is just as ridiculously fast as before. Just tap the shutter button and your photo should take pretty much instantly. And there's no denying that the iPhone 7's photography chops when it comes to everyday shots. Every photo is packed with detail and remains impressively crisp, even when blown up to crazy poster size. However, there is admittedly very little difference between the iPhone 6S and the iPhone 7's camera shots when the lighting conditions are respectable. There's not even a massive difference between photos taken on the iPhone 7 and the iPhone 6, until you zoom right in and notice that the iPhone 7 snaps do pack in a fair bit of extra detail. Of course, the big whoop with the iPhone 7's camera tech is its new low light abilities. The results really do speak for themselves. That wide aperture lens sucks in more light to produce brighter snaps than older iPhones managed, with noticeably less grain to ugly things up. Meanwhile, that built-in optical image stabilization helps to cut down on blurry results due to handshakes, which is another serious problem with low-light photography. The only problem with shooting pics on the iPhone 7's camera at night is a common complaint for smartphone snappers, and that's the length of time it takes the lens to focus. If you're in a rush to take a photo, chances are you'll miss your moment as the lens takes a couple of seconds to find its feet. Still, at least the autofocus almost always gets it right, so you'll only really get a blurry shot if your subject is in motion. And speaking of that motion blur, it's really no worse than what we got from the likes of the Galaxy S7. Pets and kids are tricky as hell to capture in low light, but you'll have no trouble taking romantic shots of your candlelit dinner date and so on. Lastly, Apple's new 4LED flash is a lot more powerful than previous iPhone flashes. Its reach is far better than before, but it's also apt to temporarily blind your subject if they're stood within about 4 feet of you. As per usual, the iPhone 7 shoots seriously impressive video footage too, up to 4K. The autofocus is quick and clean, snapping onto your subject or else giving you a wide focus for landscape shots. Changes in lighting and other conditions are well handled too, so your video footage isn't oversaturated. And we're impressed by the decent image stabilization as well, which cuts out on any judder or shake from motion. If you already own last year's iPhone 6S or 6S Plus, there's little reason to step up to the 7. Sure, there's a fair few improvements here, such as the water-resistant design and that new, better in low light camera, but nothing that'll really blow your mind. Once you get down to the iPhone 6, there's maybe a bit more reason to update, mostly that super nippy performance from Apple's A10 Fusion processor. And if you're jumping into the wonderful world of Apple mobiles for the first time, then this is undoubtedly the handset to spring for. A lack of expandable storage aside, it's one of the best blows of 2016, easily standing toe-to-toe with the likes of Samsung's Galaxy S7. For a full iPhone 7 review and tons more features and comparisons, check out recombu.com/mobile and don't forget to subscribe to the Recombu YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.